Good evening. Welcome to Current Affairs. Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, the father of the Indian Constitution, in the Constituent Assembly, so he expressed his opinion saying that Article 353 of the Indian Constitution would remain as a dead letter. So this is the expression that was made by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So when we were framing the constitution during those days. So what exactly is this Article 356? Why it has become so controversial? What was the expectation of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar and what is happening today in reality? So these are the points that should be discussed now. Under Article 356, the president can proclaim president's rule in a state. So basically what happens? Sometimes there may be a failure of the constitutional machinery at the state level. And there are different expressions for the words failure of the constitutional machinery. So whatever it is, ultimately the decision is taken by the central government. Since India being a parliamentary form of government, though we are using the name of the President of India, in reality, it is the cabinet that is headed by the Prime Minister who will take the decisions. And accordingly, that will be conveyed to the President of India, since President being a de jure head, a constitutional head, nominal head, figurehead. And the President is accepting it and the President is proclaiming the President's rules. So this is not the first time that happened in India. More than 100 times the President's rule has been imposed in various states. And whenever it was imposed, there was a contradiction. So there was a conflict and there was a criticism against the government. And the president's rule is being proclaimed by the president on the report that is submitted by the governor. Who is this governor? Governor is considered to be an agent of the central government. Governor is appointed by the president. Removed by the president. There is no security of tenure. At any time, he may be removed. And meaning there is a fear. There is a fear as far as the governor is concerned. He must listen to the directions that are given by the central government. Otherwise, the cabinet will recommend to the president of India and the governor will be removed. That is the reason why the biggest criticism against the office of the governor is that governor is an agent of the central government. So obviously what happens, because he has to take care of himself, he is just going by the directions that are being given by the so-called the central government. But is it right? So you are a constitutional head. You are the head at the state level and still, so you are giving cooperation to the central government. So though there is no breakdown of the constitutional machinery, and the governor is recommending for the president's rule, how far it is right? So many times it has been questioned. The central government, which is there in the power, is exercising Article 356 through the President of India, and it is trying to dislodge the government which is existing. And most of the times, rather every time, the government at the state level is the government that belongs to opposition party. So this is the mechanism how you will dislodge the existing government. Again, I'm repeating, this is not for the first time it has been done. When Srimati Indira Gandhi was the Prime Minister, it has been so many times it was used. Rather than saying used, it was misused during that time. And the intention is to dislodge the governments. It was also misused by Morarji Desai government. Of course, his government was a short-lived government. But even then, it was used. So like this, this is basically being used to topple the government which is present at the state level. That's the reason why it has been questioned in the Supreme Court also so many number of times. In the year 1994, in SR Bommai case, the Supreme Court has given a clear-cut ruling. President's rule cannot be declared just like that. So you need to follow certain procedures. But unfortunately, the governments of the day, they are just ignoring the directions of the Supreme Court that are given in the 1994 ruling. Just recently we have seen In Uttarakhand, what happened? President's rule has been imposed. And Supreme Court took it very seriously. When the Supreme Court was moved, it made it very, very clear it is absolutely unconstitutional. You should have given an opportunity to the government to prove its majority. So without giving an opportunity to prove the majority, without conducting the floor test, how can you dislodge? How do you come to know that there is a failure of the constitutional machinery, and how do you come to know that the government has no majority? That is the reason why. So when the president's rule has been imposed in Uttarakhand very recently, for a period of time, Supreme Court has lifted the president's rule for a period of time. Just for 2 to 3 hours, the president rule was lifted and the Supreme Court has ordered for the floor test. And during that time, floor test, Harish Rawat won the floor test, and again he has been restored back as a chief minister. For the first time in India, when the president's rule was imposed, for a period of time, it has been lifted off. Only to facilitate that democracy has to be restored. So meaning is simple, the government is just playing its role of dislodging the existing government. How a government will be established at the state level? The people of the state will go out and they will vote for a particular party, and the party which gets the majority in the assembly will form the government. So this is a system in a democracy. This is a system in democracy. And when the people have given verdict to a political party, how can you just like this topple the government? So it has been questioned by Supreme Court many, many, many number of times. And the latest example is the so-called Uttarakhand. Today, July 13th, 2016, another historical verdict has been given by the Supreme Court. I am talking to you with respect to Arunachal Pradesh. The whole scene has been started in the month of December 2015. And finally, today it has come to an end. Everything has come to an end because of the so-called this judiciary. Meaning is simple. When the central government wants to come to the power at the state level through something called backdoor entry. Backdoor entry, what we have seen in Uttarakhand, the central government has tried for this. And another example is the so-called Arunachal Pradesh. So today's verdict of the Supreme Court is considered to be backdoor entry has been backfired. Clear? So this is the second state after Uttarakhand. I am talking to you with respect to Arunachal Pradesh. That is the reason why I can say this is the second embarrassment to the central government. So some people say that it is considered to be a victory of democracy. Yes, it is a victory of democracy. We are not saying that. We are not saying that president's rule cannot be imposed. The constitution has permitted that the president's rule can be proclaimed by the president. But if the intention is malafide, and if the government wants to dislodge the existing government at the state level, then the judiciary will come into the picture. Am I clear? For example, see here, sometime back, Arunachal Pradesh governor made a statement. Every decision of the governor is not subjected to judicial review. And that is considered to be so arrogant statement that is given by Arunachal Pradesh governors. Supreme Court took it very, very seriously and said that, do you think that we should be like silent spectators? And if the slaughtering of democracy is happening, so we should just don't do anything? This is the statement that was used by the so-called the Supreme Court. Supreme Court against the governor of Arunachal Pradesh. Clear? Now, I'll just tell you the story, what exactly happened in Arunachal Pradesh, and we'll go ahead. But I don't think the problem has not come to an end. Supreme Court made it very, very clear today that the former Chief Minister Nabam Tuki has to come back to the powers. Meaning, status quo of before December 15th, 2015 must be restored. So the present Chief Minister has to step down. But today, the present chief minister is saying that there is no necessity for him to step down because, again, he wants to go for the floor test. But as far as the directions that are given by the Supreme Court, it is very clear that you need to go for the floor test, but you have to maintain the status quo. That is called turning a clock back. Yes, today, Supreme Court has turned the clock back, meaning December 15th, 2015 status has to be restored, meaning Nabam Tuki will be the chief minister and the present chief minister has to step down. Maybe Nabam Tuki, not maybe, he has to go for the floor test. But only thing is that whether he has the majority for him to prove to continue as a chief minister or not, that is very, very important. So after all, in a democracy, so this is a number game. Congress party that was there very much in the power, headed by Nabam Tuki. Unfortunately, internal conflicts in the political party promoted by the outside forces that led to the creation of some rebel Congress MLAs. So when this particular incident took place, rebel Congress MLAs, they have approached the governors, Governor Rajkova, and they requested the governor to remove the speaker. If you want to remove the speaker, again, assembly session must take place. You need to introduce a motion, and once it is accepted, then the speaker is considered to be removed. Is that okay? And they took this a drastic step because Speaker decided to disqualify some of the rebel Congress MLAs because they are mingling with some other political party and they are going against the directions of the Congress party. Clear? And what happens generally in a parliamentary democracy, governor has to go by the advice of the chief minister. But in December 2015, the governor agreed and he called for the emergency session of assembly. It happened on December 16th. And the basic intention is to take the motion for the removal of the so-called the speakers. Congress party protested against this, but the meeting took place in a hotel outside the assembly, right? And there they have taken a decision and the speaker has been removed. Today, the Supreme Court verdict made it very clear. CM has to be restored back and the speaker has to be restored back. Clear? And during this time, the central government has used or invoked the Article 356. And so during that particular time, the president's rule was imposed. And the government said that this is the breakage of the constitutional machinery at the state. Is that okay? And at the same time, the speaker during that time, he disqualified the 14 Congress rebel MLAs. And the 14 MLAs have approached the Guwahati High Court. And the Guwahati High Court has stayed the so-called, Guwahati High Court has stayed the disqualification of these MLAs. Later, what happened? Central government has declared the so-called this president's rules. And the reason is that breakdown of the land orders. Is that okay? And it also said that the Congress government is minority. Clear? Later, what happened? In February, the governor made a statement saying that whatever the president's rule that is imposed in the state is only a temporary one. Temporary one. Right? And exactly after two days, Supreme Court made a very, very, very strong statement. Governor said that governor's every decision is not subjected to judicial review. During that time, the court said that court cannot be a mute spectator when democratic process is slaughtered. Meaning the Supreme Court was very, very serious on what grounds you have imposed the president's rule. Did you follow the actual procedure as directed in the SR Mumbai case onwards? Is it okay? Later, over a period of time, in February, again in on February 19th, the president rule was lifted. So the president rule has been removed, and Kaliko Pul, he was sworn in as the so-called the chief minister of Arunachal Pradesh. And he was supported by 18 rebel Congress MLAs, plus 11 BJP MLAs and 2 independent members. BJP MLAs have given Kaliko Pul the outside support. Whatever may be the support, he proved his majority. Kaliko Pul proved majority, and today, so he is the chief minister. But now what will happen? Because the Supreme Court ordered for the restoration of December 15, 2015, now Kaliko Pul must step down, and the former chief minister has to take the office, right? Next. So this is the time, during the time Supreme Court said that we are allowing for the formation of the government. We are allowing for the formation of the government, but our proceedings will continue. So many petitions were filed in the so-called the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court has measured all the petitions, and that has been handed over to the constitutional bench. I was telling you sometime back, whenever I say constitutional bench, there minimum 5 judges will be there. How many judges? 5 judges will be there. It was a question in the civil service examination, I think 3 to 4 years back. Right? And of course, this Kaliko Pul, so he won the vote of confidence, and today, so he is the so-called the chief minister. But today's judgment or the ruling of the Supreme Court is considered to be a big blow for the central government. It's a very big embarrassment to the central government. Am I clear? So this is the background of this. But generally what is expected is that in a democracy, give respect to the verdict of the people. Because of your personal gains, don't topple the democratic government. And hopefully the present day government, NDA government, must have learned the lessons. First blow was in the form of Uttarakhand, and the second blow today in the form of Arunachal Pradesh. And obviously in future also, we expect in India that these things will not take place, right? And today what happened in Supreme Court that I would like to share with you, please have a look at this. I'll be sharing the document with you. Look at this. Today, July 13th, 2016, the Supreme Court turned the clock back and restored the Congress government in the state. The court said that the governor's actions were illegal. Clear? Now, see here, I would like to share one information with you. It's the latest news, just now it happened. Now, BJP wants to ask the court now. BJP wants to ask the court, meaning the central government wants to ask the court that who is the chief minister of Arunachal Pradesh now? So meaning is simple, when the orders are so clear, obviously Nabam Tuki has to be restored back as the chief minister, and the present person has to step down. So, but this is a mechanism to push it for a period of time. And see here, so tomorrow, if the central government goes to the court and they question the court, who is the chief minister of Arunachal Pradesh today? That will be really a funny thing. That is the reason why, whatever may be the verdict, Supreme Court has given the verdict is clear. And so many ministers in BJP today, they are saying that we did not read the ruling. After reading the ruling, then we'll come out. But the information is so clear that it is nothing but restoring back the status of December 15th means this person who is the chief minister now, he has to step down, and the old person has to, Mr. Tuki has to take the office. Clear? But the present chief minister is saying that he wants to go for the floor test. BJP government wants to ask the Supreme Court that who is the chief minister. And Nabam Tuki is ready to take the office. But the point is that if Nabam Tuki becomes the chief minister now, does he got the majority in the assembly or not? So this rebel Congress MLAs plus BJP plus independents together, so that is forming the majority now. So tomorrow, if they go for the floor test, tomorrow means maybe after 2 days or 3 days or 1 week, if Nabam Tuki becomes the chief minister and if they again go for the floor test, whether he wins the floor test or not, that is really, so we need to wait and watch. But Mr. Nabam Tuki is very confident that the so-called Congress rebel MLAs who left the party will come back. Will come back to the fold of Congress party, and again they will support for the restoration of the Congress party government in Arunachal Pradesh. So we need to wait for this. Whether you are going for the floor test, number one, whether the present chief minister steps down, paving the way for Nabam Tuki to become the prime chief minister, that is number three. Number four is that if Nabam Tuki becomes the chief minister and gets defeated in the floor test, if he wins, no problem. But winning is a very difficult task. But if he gets defeated, then what will happen? Again, Mr. Pool is going to become the chief minister, or they will dissolve the assembly and go for the elections. So all these things, so we need to wait and watch. Right? So kindly remember this one. With respect to the president's rule in the state, you may get a question this time in the main examination. I am talking about civil services. All the students who are going to write the main examination in December, you may get a question on this. Because for the first time in the history of India, president rule has been broken for a period of time. For 2 to 3 hours, there was a break during that time. Otherwise, what will happen during the president's rule? You know, this assembly is either dissolved or kept under suspended animation. Uttarakhand assembly, which was kept under suspended animation, was revived temporarily for a period of time only to see that Mr. Harish Rawat has a majority or not. Is that clear? And later, Harish Rawat, the government has been restored in Uttarakhand. Clear, that's what happened for the first time. Now, again, what happened in Arunachal Pradesh today, this is the first time in India where president's rule has been imposed, president rule has been revoked, new person became the chief minister. Now, court is saying that you have to restore the December 15 status. Obviously, what is happening, Mr. Nabam Tuki has to become the chief minister. So this is the ruling of the judiciary now. Ruling of the judiciary. Clearly, some people will say judiciary should not interfere too much into the affairs of the legislature. If judiciary is not interfering, the legislature and the executive of the day, they will keep on performing these type of activities. Then who will protect my democracy? That is a question raised by a common man in India. Am I clear? That's the reason why knowing the constitution is different. Knowing the constitutional values and implementing them is different. Am I clear? So this is a very, very unfortunate situation today what happened, and considered to be a very big embarrassment to the BJP government. Clear? Hopefully, at least now the government will not take any such drastic decisions now. Right? And it should pave the way for the smooth transfer of the power, and Mr. Nabam Tuki has to be sworn in as per the directions that are given by the so-called the Supreme Court. Supreme Court also restored the speaker. Speaker was removed, I told you, no? And again, the same person will become the speaker now. Right? I'm opening the document for a moment. Have a look at this. Yes. Look at this. In a landmark judgment, the Supreme Court said that Arunachal Pradesh Governor Jyoti Prasad Rajkova's decision advancing session of the State Assembly by a month is violative of the Constitution and is liable to be quashed. That decision is nullified. Right? The Supreme Court said all the steps and the decisions taken by the Legislative Assembly pursuant to the Governor's December 9th, 2015 order are unsustainable and liable to be quashed, gone. Whatever the decision that was taken by Governor, that's gone. Right? Look at this. The Supreme Court judgment means that the present Arunachal Pradesh government, which is headed by Kaliko Pul, would have to step down to make the way for the Congress government headed by Nabam Tuki. And the court also struck down the removal of the Speaker, Nabam Rabia, and said he would be restored back as Speaker of the House. So this is a historic verdict, as it is the first time that the apex court has put back a state government that has been dismissed by the central government under the president's rules. Right? Look at this. Supreme Court said a statement. It said that the verdict in this case will not only have its effect on Arunachal Pradesh, but it will affect the every state. Right? Now, sir, kindly follow these things. These are very, very important with respect to the examination. And you need to kindly remember some of the aspirants who write the examination, they take the sides of the government. Some people will take the side of some other political party. Kindly remember, since you are all serious aspirants, it's my friendly advice to you all. You please don't take the sides of any political party. Personally, somebody may have affection towards BJP and some other may have affection towards some other political party. That is not wrong. Some people may like Narendra Modi and some people may like Rahul Gandhi or Sonia Gandhi. Clear? That is absolutely their personal. Clear? Very, very important. And when things like today, whatever happened, this is not the time for you to take the sides. Clear? I want you to abide by the principles of the Constitution. And the Honorable Judiciary is always there, which is considered to be the guardian of the Indian Constitution, the apex court of India, the Supreme Court. So whenever these situations are happening in the country, please follow these points very clearly. Forget about your party affiliations, but your affiliation should be the Constitution of India. Whether the court is trying to restore back the principles that are enshrined in the Constitution or not, that is important for the examination. That will give you the marks. Just because somebody likes BJP, you cannot comment saying that BJP did a very good thing. Clear, BJP did a very good thing. You cannot say that, my dear close friends. Just because Congress party has been restored today, again, you cannot say that it's a good thing for Congress party and it's a lesson for the BJP party. Right? So meaning is simple. You need to look at both ends. And I want all of you, my close friends, to have a balanced view. Don't take the sides of a political party. You are taking the side of the Constitution. For that reason, you need to understand the principles of the Constitution thoroughly. It is not just your understanding, but you should make the people around you also to understand the principles of the Constitution. Then only we all become the real citizens, good citizens and honorable citizens, followed by respectable citizens as far as the great India is concerned. I know that. So we are all very good and humble citizens of India. We know what is Constitution and we also know what are the principles that are enshrined in the Constitution. That's the reason why we again pray that we will be abiding by the principles of the Constitution. Am I clear? That's the reason why kindly don't take sides. It's my a very, very close friend's advice. Is that okay? And I will stop at this stage and I'll take leave of you now and I'll see you in the next class. Till then, I wish you all the very, very best. Take very good care of yourself and thank you so much for being with me this evening. Good night.